I will now talk about COMPEX. COMPEX is a framework for building distributed abstraction. This is the framework that we are using in this course. So COMPEX was initially done by Cosmin Arad. He's now at Google in Mountain View. And it has been used in our group to build different distributed abstraction, and it is the system that is used in this course. So what we want is we want to build distributed abstractions in a simple way. And to do that, our context is a set of nodes communicating by messages. And we want to do it in a structured way, and we are going to do that by composing distributed protocols. So each node will have a stack of components, and each component represents a service or a protocol. And of course, this component will communicate with the corresponding component on other machines. So here is an example. So there is a network component in this node communicating with another network component, or communicating with the corresponding network component on other machines. For example, a failure detector abstraction is also designed as a component, and this component will provide the service that it needs to satisfy a failure detector's specification. You can think of a higher level components like consensus. It's an agreement component. This will run in coordination with other corresponding components on other machines to provide a consensus service. What's interesting about this is these components are actually concurrent components. Everyone has its own thread of control and its share of the processor that they run on. And the components do not communicate by procedure calls, but communicate by sending messages among each other. And whenever they receive messages, they are going to react to this message by executing a procedure corresponding to this message. So we are creating a system consisting of concurrent component with using message passing concurrency. To distinguish between the message inside a node and messages from one node to another node, we call these messages events. Okay, so within a single node, components communicate among others by sending and receiving events. So let us now look to the concepts that are in COMPEX. And in this lecture, we are going to see how these concepts are realized in a framework built on Java. So the first concept is an event. So an event will be objects, and these objects represent messages transferred between components on the same node. And we have the notion of port, and port is a component interface. But the component interface will be defining a set of messages that flow in and out of a component. A component is a concurrent activity that has behavior, but it will only communicate with the outside environment through its ports. A component can have multiple ports, very much an object-oriented programming language can have multiple interfaces. A channel connects components together, so a flow of events can happen from one component to another in both directions. And then we have a handler. A handler is the procedure that is called once an event is received by a component. And a subscription will actually associate handlers with specific ports and also specific events on that port. Then we have a way to for an event handler to send messages or sends events. We call it the trigger events, huh? And that is the application or triggering of events. So let's just look carefully the concept of events. Events are passive, immutable objects, huh? And they are having typed attributes or fields. Events can be typed and subtyped. It means you can subtype an event by specializing this event and adding new fields, for example. So here's an example, and this example is in the framework complex that is done in Java. There are other implementations, but in this course we're using Java. So here is an event called message. So it's a subtype of event. It has two fields or members. One is a source, it's an address, and a destination, which is having the address type. Here is a specialization of the message event, and this called data message. And data message is having two extra fields. One is a data field, called data, and a sequence number. And you can see here, that is how we denote graphically a message or an event. And you can see that data message is a subtype of message. Let's look to ports. Ports are components interfaces. Very much you have components and you want to connect them together. Here's an example, a physical example, where we have a PC and a printer. And an interface or a port will be a set of signals moving from one component to another. So we have ports, so the PC has its own port, and the printer has its own port. And the printer will provide a service to the PC. So we call the printer provides a printing service. This printing service is provided by a port type. Okay, this is a port type. And we say that the PC will have a port, but this port is of requires or uses the printing service. It requires a port type, and of course these port types have to be compatible, otherwise it's not possible for these two components to communicate with each other. Now we have this, we have also to connect these together, and we connect them with the notion of a channel. Okay, channel carry informations, carry events in bidirectional way between two components. Let's look to ports. So ports are bidirectional event-based interfaces. So a port type consists of two sets of events. One set is for request events, and the other for indication events. Request events, if you have a port connected to a component that provides a service, request events will say that these events that flow in a component, whereas indication events will be events that flow out of the component. So basically, a port type represents a service or protocol abstraction with also the direction of communication. So let us see an example in Java. So the framework provides the basic port type, and these can be extended or subtyped. So a network in its simplest form, so a network port, will provide two kinds of events flowing into the network component, which is a request event, and events flowing out of the network, which we call indication events. If we look to a timer, so you assume that you have a timer component. This timer component provides a timer port, and a timer port, the client of a timer port will request a timeout to schedule a timeout, and also can, so this is goes in, and it also can request to cancel a timeout. So the cancel will go also in. And once the time has passed, a timeout event will come out of the timer components. This is an indication event. So let us look to components with ports as an example. So here we have a network component. A network component will provide a service. This service is provided through a network port. This will allow message to flow in and messages to flow out. We also have a timer component, and the timer component will again have a timer interface. It's a port, so it provides a timer interface or implements a timer interface. And this will allow timeout to flow out of the component and schedule timeout and cancel timeout to flow into the component. That's fine. Now, given these two components, we can have another component that uses these two components. For example, a failure detector. A failure detector sends heartbeats and waits for timeout, so it's reasonable that a failure detector would use these two components. But to use these two components, the failure detector, of course, is going to provide its interface to the higher level to the application. So it provides a failure detector service, and it requires a network service, and it requires also a timer service. So now this component is actually compatible with both a network component and a timer component. So what is missing is that we have to connect these together. Okay? And we will show that through the notion of channel. And channels are the media that connects component of compatible interfaces or compatible ports together, let us say. So that's what we want to do. We want to be able to set a channel to connect the failure detector with the network component and to connect the failure detector with the timer component. And you do it by what we say, channels connect complementary ports. If a component provides a service and the failure detector uses the service, okay, then we can connect these two complementary components together. So provides will be connected to a required version of the interface. And it should be of the same type. So network connects to network, it's matching ports, and events flowing through these channels will be forwarded in a FIFO order in both directions. Okay. So what's an event handler? Once you receive an event on a port, the component can trigger a handler that executes on the reception of this event. And these are event handlers. So event handlers are procedures that will be activated once a component receives an event. In this framework, a handler is not just a method or a procedure, but it is a first-class component procedure accepting a particular type of event and executed reactively upon receiving the event. What a handler can do? A handler I didn't say about, but a component is a concurrent encapsulated activity, it has its state, it has its handlers, so it can mutate the local state of its corresponding component and can trigger or send new events. These new events will be sent through the ports of the component, of course. And handlers of one component are mutually exclusive. It means a running component is a concurrent activity that is sequential. It can handle one event at a time. So here is an example in Java to define a handler. This handler will be activated on the reception of a data message event. As I said, handlers are first class. To do this in the current Java implementation or language, we have to do it by creating an object. So objects are first class in Java, and that's the only way we can do to make handlers first class. So we do this by creating an object from an anonymous class. This anonymous class extends a handler class and provides a specific handle procedure or method to handle the message. So you can see here, so what we do, we create an object from an anonymous class that is extended by this new handle method. So all handlers have to have a handle method. So what this does is that once you receive a data message, for example DM, you increment the local state of the component local state of the component where this handle exists, and then you send new messages. In this case, we use this trigger method to send messages, and it will be sent to some of the ports accessible within in the scope of this component encapsulating the handler. So there is some port, so it sends message receive on a some port, and it sends an acknowledgement message on a network port. Okay, and you can see the acknowledgement actually sends an event. This event has number of fields, the source of the message, the sequence number, and my address, for example. Subscriptions and publication. An event handler has to subscribe to ports. So the notion of an event handler, once you create an event handler, you still have to subscribe to a port so that it can handle the events coming out of this port. And the events coming out of this port that is going to handle is the event that is matching the type of handler that specified. So subscription binds an event handler, say H, to a local component port, say P. So here is a situation. So this event handler, which we have seen in the previous slide, handle data, is an event handler of type data message. So we want to subscribe this event handler to the network port. And once you subscribe the event handler to the network port and a message arrives from the network, it will trigger two events, one that goes to some port and the other goes to the network again. That's what we have seen in the previous slide. Okay, and that's what's going to happen. So now let E be the type of a handler. So a handler, as I said, the type of a handler is the type of the event it can process. And let F be a super type of the event E. So a network component, for example, can provide an interface with events of type E. So can provide interface with events of type E, But you can subscribe a handler to a subtype of that event, for example, data message or acknowledgement message. The network only has to have an interface that provides, in this case, a message event type. So F must be coming in on the port. So this F is, this is coming in, okay. And after subscription, what we are going to do is H will handle all events of any type D, a subtype of E oncoming on P. So basically, what we are saying is that if here we have this interface provides an event of type F, the handle could handle a subtype of this F events and or any subtypes of F, so for example D, which would mean it is possible for this network interface to be general and the component be specific to handle specific subtypes of the message flowing into from the network. Okay, so let's look now to the active entity components. Components are instantiated from component definitions. So component definition is basically Java classes. And a component instance is an object that contains local state variables, ports, both the require and provide service ports, event handlers, subscriptions of the event handlers to the ports, and it can also have other components inside. This we call encapsulated subcomponents, and we have local channels to connect subcomponents together or to connect to connect subcomponents together, and these will form a containment hierarchy that starting at one big component, we call it main. So everything is in, all other components are encapsulated inside main.